Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here, and I'm excited to share with you a new software that I've been using to ingest, process, and tag my video footage before I send it to Premiere Pro for editing. And it's called Kino by Less Pain Software. So the best part of Kino is that it makes it easy to prep your footage for editing. So that way later on, you don't have to spend so much time organizing and you can just focus on actually doing the creative part of editing, right? So I have some footage that I shot in February in San Francisco when I was visiting my family, and I want to make a travel vlog. So I have my SD cards here ready, and I'm ready to import them with Kino to edit in Premiere Pro. So be sure to download the trial version of Kino. I left a link in the description box below, and let's go ahead and show you how I use Kino. So now that I'm inside of Kino, you'll see that here under Devices on the left, I can access all the media on my hard drive, as well as from my SD card called EOS Digital, which is the card I want to get all the footage from. You can see this drill down folder at the top is turned on. What this does is literally drill down to find and reveal all of the media that I have within the folder selected. Since I also shot photos on my camera, Kino makes it easy for me to sift through and narrow down my content with these media icons at the top. So what I'm going to do is turn off audio and photos so I can just see the video that I want to import. You can also use this feature to filter through footage you already have on your computer or hard drive. It doesn't have to be from an SD card. I also like to increase the size of the thumbnail using the zoom slider in the lower right corner to review the footage and make sure that I'm going to import only the footage that I want. Then I'm going to hit Command A to select all the clips here in the folder. And then I'm going to drag it over to the folder on my external hard drive, Gal, into a folder called San Francisco, into a folder called Video on the left panel. This will copy over all the footage from the SD card to the drive that I want to import. The next thing that I do in Kino is I like to go through and add metadata to all the newly imported footage. If you double click on a clip, it'll show you all this info, such as the file size, when it was created, the format, how long the clip is and the duration, resolution, and much more. You can also play the clip back with Kino's impressive player, which can play back almost all formats and even 4K. It really has all the features of a professional video player. Here, I also like to add in and out points using I and O to grab the portion of the shot I definitely know that I will use. Sometimes the camera's a little shaky and I only want that moment that's nice and still. You can even add markers if you like. On the right, now depending on how detailed you want to get, you can add further info. I like to add a title and description, as well as detail what camera I used and some tags. This may seem like a lot of work, but ultimately will save you time if you ever want to find some of these shots later on. You can also convert this footage into a different codec for audio, video distro on YouTube, and editing. Or you can open it up in another video player if you like. You can also export the video to Final Cut. Or if you're like me, I want to send it to Premiere Pro for editing. But before I do that, I'm first going to add metadata to the rest of the clips that I'd like to ingest, and then I'm going to batch send them to Premiere Pro. So now that I'm done adding metadata to all the clips, I now want to send it to Premiere Pro. I'm going to hit Command A to select them all, and then I'm going to right click and click on Send to Premiere Pro. This will create a new Premiere Pro project if you don't have one open, or if you already have a Premiere Pro project open, it'll import all these clips into the current project you have. You will see that the name of each video clip was changed to the title that I gave it to Kino, so it's not some generic MVI underscore 1823 or something like that. It's actually the title that I gave it inside of Kino, the title that will be for me easy to recognize. If you added any markers or in and out points in Kino, you will see that those also transferred over into Premiere Pro. When you double click on a clip and open it up in the source panel, you'll see the markers and the in and out points. So now I'm in a much better place to start editing my vlog. I know where everything is. So Kino is a really great starting point and a great way to just ingest and stay organized, and super fun if you're a metadata nerd like me. So I hope that you guys found this tutorial useful. Kino is awesome, and there's tons of other features that you need to explore. There's an awesome video denoiser, the ability to export frames from many video clips at once for social media or your YouTube thumbnails. There are lots of awesome things to explore. So go ahead and download the trial in the link below. So I make new video production tutorials every week based on your requests. If you go to premieregal.com/tutorials, leave your request there, and I look forward to reading it. I will see you guys very soon. Bye!